If you're my volunteer, I'm going to call you up here and hand you this bell. Then I'm going to begin telling everyone a story, and anytime you want, you can ring the bell. When you do, I have to stop, go back and repeat what I said, but change it. So if my story was, once upon a time, there was a girl with a pet dog. Once upon a time, there's a girl with a pet cat, with a pet mouse, with a pet emu, with a pet eggplant, like whatever. Whenever you ring, I change. When you stop ringing, I keep going, but only as if I said the last thing. So in this example, the dog, the cat, the mouse, and the emu would be gone. We'd have a story about a girl and her pet eggplant. So that's all there is to it. You don't have to improvise. You don't even really have to speak. So could I get a volunteer who'd be willing to be my bell ringer for this opening exercise? Oh, there's a hand way up high right back there. Come on up. Excellent. And what is your name?
Amanda.
Amanda. Let's give Amanda a big round of applause. So Amanda, I'm going to stay a good 6 feet away from you. You grab the bell over there. So first thing, Amanda, is go ahead and give it a test ring. Very nice. You'd be surprised how many people mess that up, so good job.
I don't know what you heard, but I said respect.
Oh, respect. Well, just imagine the second half of the word and how that could be misunderstood, which would make the world a better place. Okay, so Amanda, I'm going to work on the assumption you've never done this before. There's no right or wrong way, but there's a rhythm that might make it more or less fun. So if I want you to ring the bell more often, I will give you the let's go faster signal. If I want you to slow down and ring less frequently, I will give you the let's get off the caffeine signal. Okay? I will say if you're uncertain, err on the side of ringing the bell more, because that's going to make it more fun for the group.
Okay,
are you ready?
I'm ready.
Then here we go. Once upon a time, there was a woman and she lived in a big house. And she lived in a tiny, tiny shack. She was very poor and she had no money because she had no job. She had lots of money, but she was very miserly. And she just hoarded it all the time. Well, her kids came to her one day and said, Mom, why don't you spend some of the money you have? They said, Mom, you should just die so we can inherit your money since you're not using it anyways. And she said, listen, I'm going to live a good life. I'm happy in my little things. Don't try to kill me off. Well, the kids really did decide to hatch a plan to maybe murder her off because they wanted to. They hatched a plan to get her married because they're like, look, if she gets married, then that will make her die younger because that's the way marriage goes, according to them. So they set her up with this guy and they set her up with another woman because they didn't know her taste and they wanted to be open-minded. And she went on this date with this woman and she was really taken with her. And she's like, wow, this woman is really attractive and this is an ugly woman, which means I'm not intimidated and I can be myself. But the other woman didn't like her at all. The other one also loved her because, like, you're ugly too. We're both ugly, ugly people. So they got married. Right there that day, they said, let's go get married. So they said, let's never get married. Let's just spend all the money now before your kids can hatch their plan, and then they'll get nothing in the inheritance. Well, the kids were observing the date from the table, and they leaned in at this moment, and they started yelling at the mother. They threw spaghetti at the mother because they wanted the other woman to see. All right, now I've lost where that story's going. Let's stop right there. Let's give Amanda a big round of applause. Thank you.
Is that it?
Yes, if you'll hold on 1 second. Amanda, to thank you for being a brave first volunteer, I'm going to give you a copy of one of my books called Say Yes And. Amanda, ladies and gentlemen.